Hombre, para hacer jacono, tienes que ver ahí.
So this completes the verses on the path, and then next and mainly today we will deal with the fruition. And it says, like space, awareness is the universal ground and starting point. So that's actually similar to Lord Chikden Sumgen's quote that we mentioned the other day, where he said, mind itself is like the open sky. So when you look at these, both these lines, you can really see how they really speak about the same point. So in the beginning, when we practice and meditate, we see this space like sky, like nature of the mind for a brief moment. For a brief moment, you rest in the actual natural state of the mind, and you see, you experience the space like nature. But very quickly, again, you are confused and thoughts arise again. But you have seen it for a very brief while. And at that time, you have had an experience, albeit a brief experience. But the experience was an experience of complete happiness and ease, and a space like open feeling and experience. And that has not lasted for very long, but you did have that experience. And now when you look back at that brief moment of experience, then you remember when I have meditated that time, I felt this way. I felt so happy and peaceful. And so what you have experienced is the space-like nature of the mind. And the nature of space has a lot of qualities. So from the one hand, it seems that space is like nothing. How can it have a quality? But actually, it has a lot of qualities. First quality is that space doesn't come and doesn't go. Second quality of space is that it is without center and boundary. And so just take those two qualities and apply them to your mind and see, how does that, is that true for my mind? So the sky is without center and boundary. How is it in my mind? How is there a center or a boundary? Is there coming and going in my mind? When you understand that the mind transcends coming and going, then you have understood that the mind is never born and it never dies. And when you realize that, then outer appearances and inner mind become the same. It's like becoming one. And so you realize that you never go anywhere. So now it seems to us that we are coming and we are going. But what's really happening is the thoughts are coming and going. Milarepa also said, when you die, it's your thought that dies. You think you die. And when you're sick, you think you're sick. It's your thought that's sick. Actually, the mind is not sick. The mind will not die. But for example, we think that in my mind, I've been in going to India and going to China and going to different places and so on. But in that time, what does really happen? Is it that the mind goes really anywhere, or is it that something comes to the mind? So the mind doesn't go anywhere, but momentarily things, thoughts flash up in the mind, and then that gives you the illusion of I'm going somewhere. The mind went there, but actually it didn't go anywhere. There is no coming and no going in the mind, and if there is, then it is confusion. It doesn't really happen. And this confusion arises due to the dualistic perception of self and other. Gampopa had also said in the jewel ornament of liberation, easy to understand, he explained it in an easy way. So he explained in this text what is confusion. And confusion, the actual confusion, is this belief in a duality, that self and other really exist. basically you are confused by whatever you think. Any kind of thought that arises, that is the confusion, that's delusion. So when it arises and you instantly recognize it, then you have returned to your natural state. Actually, there is no coming and going. For example, in the empowerment, we are introduced to the nature of mind, the space-like nature of mind, by means of the substance, the empowerment substance of a crystal ball, a piece of crystal. So when we look at the crystal and things are reflected within it, like a mirror, then is it that the mirror goes out to the object that it reflects, or is it that the reflection comes to the mirror and then is reflected within it? So we can understand that the mirror, the crystal, doesn't go to the object, but the object comes to the crystal and is reflected there. So that is like with the space-like nature of the mind that has no center and no boundary. All those objects that appear they come to the mind, they are reflected within the mind. Everything is reflected within the mind. The mind never goes anywhere. Everything happens within the mind. So when you understand that the mind doesn't come and doesn't go, it always remains as it is, then actually your meditation practice will become so much more stable and easeful and much more fruitful. You will really find that meditation you really begin to understand the meaning of meditation when you understand this point. So in the beginning, it is important to understand especially this quality of space and apply it to mind. And that is that space or the mind doesn't come and doesn't go.